Ok. Today's video is gonna be very spontaneous. I tell you already. Bonjour Fragrance Lovers, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're gonna do a first impression. Well, not technically, I've tried it few weeks ago, but it's been long. We're gonna try together a niche house and a French one. I didn't prepare anything except how to introduce the brand. We're gonna discover them blindly, and then after we're gonna watch the ingredient together. Let's see what's happened. So the house is called Violet Parfum, created a long time ago actually, because it was in 1827 by Monsieur Violet, and unfortunately the house shut the doors in 1955, but a few years ago, maybe a month, I'm not too sure of that, I need to check. Anyway, so Anthony Tout le Monde, Victorien Siro et Paul Richardo sont trois étudiants. Why am I speaking French? Jesus, there are three students in the École supérieure du parfum, so it's a national school of fragrance in France. They build a very friendship around that passion that they have together. They also discover that they really love the 20th century perfume. The idea of restoring a house that is forgotten came really to their mind, and they wanted to modernize a classic. So when I read that, I was expecting something slightly vintage and staying in the tradition of the French perfumery. And in France, we love flowers and we know how to use them in a very delicate way, quite poetic. So I'm imagining something like that. Anyway, we're gonna start. Okay, so the first one is a sample like that. So they kindly sent to me their sample, which was very lovely. If they see that video, thank you very much. So it's called Cycle 001 or Cycle 1 Limited Edition Range. So I think they will change it. Maybe Cycle 2 will be in a year. I'm not too sure. What is nice with it, if you own Cycle 1, you will be able to refill it. This one is a floral mask. It's produced in France, apparently. Purely like French. Yeah, I spray a lot. Oh, it smells very musky to me. Cottony, clean. A bit powdery as well. There's a very uplifting start. And I can feel some pepper. Like it's a bit, there's something a bit spicy. I don't know if it's pepper. There's something that is projecting a lot the brightness. So it's not like a citrus brightness, but there's something really projecting, nearly like you spray some powder. It's quite floral, but at the same time, very powdery. It seems to be quite delicate. So it's something that will leave you like a cloud of powder. I really like that, honestly. It makes me think of a pure white color. I want to see what's inside. Pink pepper. I knew it was pink pepper because it's a pepper that smells a bit yummy and it's tickling your nose when you're smelling it. So that really brightened the fragrance. So I forgot to say, Violet Parfum, obviously, I think you're gonna have a lot of violet and iris. Iris is like a violet flower, but it's those two smell very powdery. You need to enjoy that. Think of your favorite iris fragrance, Diorum, for example, or Prada Infusion d'Iris. If you like those things, you're gonna like this. The iris give a bit of powdery. That's why I told you it was projecting, is because of the Ambroxan. Ambroxan uplift the fragrance, give a burst. It's really nice. It's delicate, powdery, but if you like powdery skin scent, it's nicely balanced as well, because it's not just a complex powder, it's like a bit uplifting. That's for the lovers of iris, definitely. Smell a bit green slightly as well. Really nice. I like that. I like gentle though. You need to enjoy a bit of gentle fragrance. If you're here for the beast mode, that's not for you. We're gonna try is Tanagra. Oh, much more heavy. Round, a bit sweeter. But there's again something tickling in my nose, a bit spicy. It's more feminine, much more feminine, this one. Very elegant, powdery, nearly smelling like a lipstick. Blushy effect, very blushy. Again, it's very powdery. It smells a bit violet-like, like, you know, the little violet bonbon. Honestly, I think it's something that will sink and indulge into your skin. It smells so clean. Smell like a cashmere as well. It's very soft and velvety. So you do have really that musky tone, definitely. I'm not surprised to see peony because I could tell it was smelling more feminine. Peony flower is a very, to me, sweet flower. You can smell the pear after, and you know how much I love pear fragrance. It's like a very romantic floral scent with a bit deeper undertone, very powdery. It's very beautiful. It's really nicely done. That's a true French perfumer. Okay, let's try the second one. The third one. For now, I would say it's a bit more feminine. Unless you're a man and you like this a bit more floral tone, which is nice. I think on men, you need to be, you know, daring a little bit. So this is called Un Air d'Apogée. What's this? That's weird. It smells like a morning cloudy day. But there's something a bit that smells like a polished shoe. Oh, okay, that's leather, the polished shoe kind of feeling. I can really feel the honey now. It smells nearly mystical. That's the sage as well. The sage gives like a very mystical, nearly religious tone to a fragrance. It's nice though. It's very unusual. Mimosa, so it's quite flowery, and mimosa smell powdery as well, like a bit. It's a discreet flower with a green undertone. Really interesting though, I never smelled something like that before. The honey is like not warm, is the hint inside, just like something peppery inside the fragrance. And there's like really this skin like scent with the leather. It's very strange. I don't even know when I'm gonna wear that. It's just like you have a powdery something, and then inside you have like a hint of honey that is like pinching your nose. It smells like a breakfast to me. Next one. It's a bit more like a, I don't know, first thing that comes to my mind is something very like a marine freshness. Oh, there's a bright floral tone, but there's an undertone a bit fresh, nearly minty, very clean, that's for sure. Less powdery than the other ones. Intense brightness, nearly like the sun is rising. Very bright citrusy undertone. The earthy, powdery, violet-like scent. Can really smell the lemon tone. The lemon is really here. Or maybe it could be quite sexy as well. But the bright lemon makes me want to wear it during the day. It's definitely a blue undertone because it feels a bit more, you know, it's not on the warm side, like creamy warm. It's more on the colder undertone. So blue tone. I feel this one compared to the other one is a bit more modern to me, so maybe more easy to approach because it's got really a bright opening and then a bit of flower and then a bit of woody notes. So I think they're very like elegant and Frenchy. Like I cannot see any of those very overpowering, and I really like that. Maybe for someone that likes skin scent, stuff like that you really enjoy the delicacy of French perfumery, that could be good. It's made in a traditional way, but Nuit Bleue has got a twist of modernity. Well, they all have a twist of modernity with mixing traditions. Okay, so now we have Sketch. It's bright yellow, so I'm expecting something a bit more hardcore. Oh, that is much more powerful. Smell a bit boozy to me. Something like vanilla and things like that. Ah, that's nice. Oh, that's an evening to me. I would wear that on an evening, a bit more sexier. A bit like this cocktail-like scent, a bit like a whiskey to me. Vanilla and tongue cabin create that really like cocooning warmness. This is much more masculine. Deep oriental, a bit cocooning, but with a very bright undertone. You can smell the flower, but it's not really feminine. I really like that. You've got again this pink pepper that is brightening the whole composition, give you something quite yummy. It's much more intense, much more heavy. Contrast something dark and something luminous. It's very strange. You can smell again that powdery like effect. Vibrant, it's living, it's contrasted. Early cinnamon like, I know there's none, but I can smell something like that. And the last one, but not the least, pourpre d'automne. Ooh, for me, that's the signature. It smells violet flower, the violet bonbon. Oh, that is projecting a lot of that. It's beautiful. It smells like spring flowers. Very powdery. You need to enjoy something ultra powdery. This makes me think of Missia from Chanel, that lipstick tone. Very fluffy. Oh my god, if you like violet flower, it's amazing. And you've got this peach that is just, is not really there. It's really, I think, boosting the violet. So drama queen to me. Like, it's elegant, eccentric. I will see someone with a great personality wearing that ladylike. It's really nice and it's not heavy, because Missia from Chanel is really heavy. This one, it's got a bright opening, and I think because it's very clever to have put fruit in there. Overall, I think violet parfum are very in the tradition of French perfumery, using flowers in a very delicate way. Really refined ingredients, showing a lot of savoir-faire of the French perfumery, so I really enjoy that. I feel all the fragrances are very elegant and extremely nicely blended. I feel there's a lot of research, slightly more feminine to me because we play more on the flowery side, but again, that's niche fragrances. You should wear whatever you like, and if you like this purple color, violet color, a bit powdery, musky feeling, you're gonna really enjoy that. There's really a good quality in there. Cycle one, the most musky one to me. Clean, a bit earthy. Really like you smell the powder, and more delicate than the other one. Agra is a bit more uplifting, is a happy scent to me. It's got this bright, vivid tone. Nair apogée. That's a breakfast for me. Of honey, it's just so yummy. It's very strange, and you've got this polished shoe tone behind. I'm tempted to get a bottle of that, honestly. I really like it. I have Nuit Bleue, more deep now, like more grey tone. It's really like a cold tone, flower-like. You can really smell the citrus at the beginning. It's easier scent of the collection to reach for, especially for men. It does have a freshness for men that could be really nice. Well, I would really see that on a man, actually. It's quite nice. But even for me, like, I really like it. Sketch. Sketch is projection, orientals, warm vibe, sexiness, opulence. Oh, yeah, it's really opulent. Intense floral tone. Charming, mysterious, a bit more deeper, but still a bright luminosity. I love that. I really, really love that. Pourpre d'automne. That's the lipstick scent, the diva, the queen. Probably Sketch will be something I would really enjoy to wear, especially with the season coming. But honestly, all of them nicely blended. There's one for everyone, I have to say. But yeah, that's the pure epitome of French perfumery. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. I need to go now. please subscribe to my channel and activate the little bell to see when I'm launching videos. And thank you for everyone that has been on my uTip. uTip is is an application. If you go on the link down below in my description, you can go and watch free advertising. It gives me a little tip, so it's always nice and rewarding. So thank you for everyone that did it. I will see you. Oh, you will find all the details of Violet Parfum, the website and the Instagram down below as well, if you want to have a little look. The website is really nicely done and you have picture of the ingredients, so it's quite nice. I will see you very soon. Bye now.